Hey there, welcome to the second part of this tutorial. In the first part, we tried to approximate pi using the Monte Carlo approach and also using the Leibniz formula, both of which converge rather slowly to the actual value of pi. And therefore, we are going to try it again today with two other approaches. So let's get started. The approaches which we are going to use for the second part of the tutorial are the Bailey-Borwein-Plouffe formula and also the Chudnovsky algorithm. You can directly start with the first one, the BBP formula. This formula is basically a series where each term of this series consists of five different elements. And in order to code it a bit tidier, I'm going to compute all of these terms separately and then compute the respective term of the series. I have imported a text file which contains the first 1000 digits of pi. And then I have also defined a function which takes in our estimate as input and then checks whether all of the first 1000 digits of our estimate are correct, or it can also return the index of the digit where it differs from the actual value of pi. Here I have also imported the decimal library for better representation of decimals. So let's get started by defining the function which takes in as input k, the total number of terms that we want to generate. We need to set the precision. We'll set it to 1000 digits. Then we need to also define the starting value. And then we need to do the summation. So we are going to compute each term separately. It's important to define your variables as decimals before you do any multiplication or basically any division on them, so that the accuracy of the digits will remain intact. Okay, great. Now we need to update our estimate. And that should be it. Okay, let's test our function. First generate the first 1000 terms of this series, and then we just want to have a look at the first 17 characters. I say 17 because it's the same as the total number of digits that we see from the pi in math library. Then we can compare them both, and we can also use the function that we have written to check how many digits have been estimated correctly. As you can see, the first characters that we see are fully correct, and our function also tells us that our estimate is correct to the first 1000 digits. So we can see that this method converges very fast and very accurately predicts the digits of pi. Okay, now it's time for our second approach, the Chudnovsky algorithm. The formula for this algorithm, which was proposed by the Chudnovsky brothers, looks like this. And I'm sure that you can admit it that it looks simultaneously cool and also a bit scary. But no worries, we are going to again break it down to its underlying parts. and then it would look much simpler at least. And because the right hand side of this equation is equal to 1 over pi, we need to reverse it to get to the actual value of pi. And that's exactly what we're going to compute now. Similar to the last approach here, I have also imported the list of the first 1000 digits of pi and the libraries that we need. Let's start by defining the function for our algorithm, where q is the total number of terms that needs to be generated. We define the precision to be a bit higher than the total number of terms that we need. So this, we define a starting value for the right hand side. It's going to be 0. Then we are going to update it in each iteration. We need to loop q times, and I'm going to compute each underlying element separately. So as you can guess, because this approach has lots of factorials, it's going to be fast, basically slower than the previous one. For the last term, we're going to first compute its power. Then raise it to its power. We need to update our storage, basically. Great. Let's test it for the first 1000 terms. It took about 40 seconds for these results to be calculated, so it's definitely slower than the previous approach, but it still brings promising results, and all of the first 1000 digits of pi have been correctly approximated. Now with that, this tutorial comes to an end. I will post the codes on my website and then share the link to that post in the captions. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you in my next tutorial.